talk about what's in my camera bag. We'll start off with the bag itself. I picked up this bag here locally, but you can find it online. Oh gosh, I forget the name of it. I'll put that in the description. I'll have all of these things in the description. The main reason why I went with this bag though is because it is small, compact, but it's still an actual camera bag. You'll see what I'm talking about when I open it up in a second. The bag in general has a nice strap that's adjustable. It's like seatbelt material. It's really strong. Nice construction. It's a really durable quality bag. I'll save what's in the accessory pockets for the end, and one of them I recently started using and has definitely elevated the quality of my foodie video content. So let's jump into the bag. So I'll just pull out from the top and we'll work our way down. So this is the new Crane M2S. I just picked this up about 2 months ago, right when it came out. Three things that I love about it is it's a lot smaller than the other gimbals that I use. The motors are pretty strong, and I think it can support up to like an A7 S3 with a prime lens on there. And the third thing that I love most about this is the battery lasts 10 hours. Amazing small little gimbal, gets the job done, and it fits in this bag, which is great. Up next, and this is the Rode VideoMic 2. I recently just picked this microphone up as well, and I've been using it more than my more expensive Rode wireless video NTG mic. I think it was like 250. This thing's $100. Quick fire, the reasons why I like it. One, it's cheap and affordable, $100. It's a lot smaller than my other microphone. You don't need to charge it or anything, so you don't have to worry about the batteries dying or it not being charged when you need to use it. I think it has more directional pickup. I've noticed like the quality of this is almost, I wanna say, better than my more expensive Rode VideoMic NTG. Overall, it's just an amazing mic for its price. It's small, compact, it just works. Highly recommend it, $100. Up next is this compact tripod that I got from Sanmark. This thing is amazing. They actually gave this to me for free and they've been asking me for a video on it for the longest time, and I've just been kind of dragging my feet, but I've been shooting a lot of content with this. You know, four things that I love about it the most is that it is small and compact, like as you can see. It's made of aluminum. If you wanted to use it, it can extend up to 25 inches if you wanted to use it as a real tripod, but I use it for my foodie content, and I love that it has a small footprint like this because I can set it up like this, I can put my camera on it, and it's at that perfect height for me to set the camera up, and then it's like at eye level with me. So when I'm eating or doing anything on camera, it's perfect. And like I said, it has a small footprint, so it doesn't take up too much space like on the table that I'm eating at a restaurant. It has a great ball head on it. I love the center column on it as well because I can adjust that height easily. If I wanted to just bring that up and shoot down on my food, for example, or raise it up or lower it for when I'm filming myself while I eat. I did change out the head on this tripod though to one that has the same quick release plate that I use on my camera. And I'll show you that in a minute. Amazing tripod. And it breaks down so small, like the size of a water bottle. That's the Sanmark tripod. Highly recommend it. So the camera that I'm using is the Sony ZV-1. Fire off the things that I love about it. It's small, compact. It has the flippy screen. It has a amazing microphone that's built in, but then you can add a microphone on there as well. So it has the microphone jack input. And I think one of the other features that I love most about it, product showcase mode. I can show like my food or products to the camera, and I can do like, I can open it up or I can hold it up. And then when I go to eat it, the focus moves back to me while I'm eating, and I can describe what it tastes like on camera. On the ZV-1, I have a small rig camera cage, and the three reasons why I love it is because it is metal and it protects the camera. It also has like a 1/4-20-inch screw all around. And one of the biggest flaws I think of the ZV-1 was the placement of the tripod mount. When you have a quick release plate on there, you're not able to open the battery to access the battery or memory card. So with these extra mounts on the bottom, I'm able to relocate my quick release, and then I'm able to access the battery and memory card. Also, it has the 1/4-20s on the side as well. So I'm able to screw my quick release plate on there and mount it vertically on my tripod. Right next to that in the bag, I have my memory card case, and I actually wouldn't recommend this case. The reason why I don't like this case is because the cutouts that are made for holding the memory cards, they only fit one way. So a lot of times when I'm filming, what I like to do is I like to be able to flip my card over and put it upside down. So that means I know that I shot on that card, or I know that I didn't copy that memory card's data off onto my computer yet. And this doesn't allow me to flip the memory card. So my workaround right now is I usually just move it from one side to the other. And then that's how I know that I shot on those cards. But I wouldn't recommend this case, honestly. It's what I got. I bought it and I didn't want to throw it away. Next to that in here, I have a wide angle lens. The ZV-1, it has the built-in 24-70 lens, one of the things that I love about it. But if you needed a little bit more reach, this wide angle lens adapter screws onto the front and it'll turn it into an 18 millimeter. For you to be able to screw it on the front, there is an adapter that you need to stick onto the camera, and then you let it like chill overnight, and then you're able to screw the lens onto the camera. I think one of the benefits of using the wide angle lens is that when you're using the active image stabilizer on the ZV-1, it kind of crops in a little bit. So throwing the wide angle lens on there kind of brings back that wide shot that you need in some situations, especially if you're just like holding your camera out and doing like vloggy style content. But yeah, amazing lens, $50, totally worth it. It's actually two lenses in one. You can screw the lens in half, and then the other half, the smaller half, is a macro lens. So if you wanted macro shots, you have that option too. So if you look at the inside of the bag, it's actually like a camera bag. There's these little separators that are soft, and you can move them around. So you can customize the bag to fit the gear however you would like it to fit. I'm able to put my tripod and my gimbal and all my things in there. It just works perfect. And if I wanted to use it as a regular bag, I could just rip everything out and then it becomes my man purse. In this front pocket here, I keep a bunch of accessories, mainly a lot of batteries. One of the downsides of the ZV-1 is it has a terrible battery life, especially if you're shooting like 4K. So I have a few extra batteries in there that I use. And then on the case itself, I put a label. I labeled them like used. So then that way I know whenever I'm done using the battery, or if that battery dies, I'll make sure to put the Sony logo, and I'll face that towards the used part. And then that way I know that I used that battery. That's my little workflow. I also have some lens wipes. The lens wipes are just some Zeiss wipes. They look like little wet naps when you pop them open, and they're perfect for cleaning off the lenses as well as the external or the back monitor screen. Those are great. I buy like 150 pack. I also have a Apple, what is it called? Like an AirTag. And I put that in here just in case I misplace my bag or if it gets stolen. I actually want to relocate that somewhere in the bag. I'm thinking of just like pulling some stitches and like tucking it in. So then that way, if someone did steal my actual bag, they won't find that and just throw that out. Another thing I have in here to help with cleaning the lens is some Q-tips. The weird thing about the ZV-1 lens is it's built in, but it has like these shutters that kind of like open and close around it. And sometimes it's kind of difficult to get in there with just my finger using the wipes. So I'll wrap a wipe around a Q-tip and I'll kind of go in there and get in there a little bit better with the Q-tip. But that's what I have in those main pockets here. Before I jump into these other pockets and show you the accessories, I just want to mention that I plan on posting a lot more how to shoot foodie style content. I know that there's a lot of people that are already out there that do this, and what I'm hoping to do is try and help you create better looking foodie style content. Like I was saying earlier, shooting cooking content is really difficult, especially just buying the ingredients, cooking it, filming it, and then like having to clean everything up. There's just so many things that you have to do to make one video. But the foodie style content, it's just showing up, filming, and eating, and then you can edit that video. And I was able to pump out a lot more of that content a lot quicker, which pretty much skyrocketed my like social media following. So I'm just hoping that I can help you create better food content. And if that sounds like something you're interested in, consider subscribing. So in this front pocket here, I actually have a pouch with all of my reusable utensils. One thing that we try and do is use a lot less single-use plastic. So I have this utensil case here that has a few utensils that we use. I have a straw in here with a cleaner. I never really use straws, but I definitely hate paper straws. If I wanted to buy a milkshake or something, I would use this to drink with. I also have a pair of chopsticks in there that I got from Japan. And then I have some actual utensils themselves, and these are pretty cool because they kind of all lock into each other and they're nice and thin. So if I needed a fork, knife, or spoon, I have that in the case too. So we will ask for no utensils, and then I'll use my own utensils when we can. One of my favorite accessories, and one that I've been using to elevate my food content, my foodie content, is this light. And it fits perfectly inside of the back of the bag. LoomCube has a light that is used specifically for video conferencing. And I saw this on their website and I was like, hey, this looks like I could use it for food content. And what I love about it is that it came with this like extension pole and tripod. And one of the downsides or most difficult things about shooting food videos, especially at a restaurant, is, you know, like holding your camera and then holding a light. And what I love about this is that it has this tripod that extends up to 30 inches, and then I can actually point, crap, I'm missing that piece. Oh no, it's in here. And then it extends up to 30 inches, and then I can even point this down, and I can use it to light my food, and then I can set my camera up on my tripod, and I can use that to film, and then I have both of my hands free now where I can manipulate the food, I can cut it, I can pull it open, I can move the plate around, I can do whatever I want. And it's a nice, small, compact setup like you could see here, so I could fit all of this onto a small table at a restaurant. And this is the probably best or most amazing setup. That's super convenient. The light itself is pretty inexpensive and it's really bright. I would say bright enough to get, you know, the shots that I want to get, as well as you can adjust the color temperature of it. So a lot of the restaurants that we shoot in, that's more of that yellowy 3200 Kelvin, and this goes down to 3200 and I think goes up to about 6000. So if you're filming in like daylight in the more blue light, you have that option here to change this as well. I just recently got hosted at a hotel on Maui, and the trade that I had to do with them was just make them 2 TikTok videos eating at their restaurants. And I did a whole behind the scenes of that trip, and I'll be sure to share a link, or I'll have it pop up over here once that video's done, so you can check it out and you can see me using this gear in the wild. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this and found some value, and I'll catch you in the next one. Aloha.